from Matthew chapter 9, verse 27 to 31. That is the miracle of two blind persons who came and asked God for mercy. They asked Jesus to be healed, and they were able to see. I want to take part here of the gospel and put it in the context of this week in which I have been speaking about Synod and what can we learn from St. Joseph. What can we learn from the Holy Family? En este día, pues, en esta conferencia, esta homilía, lo que quiero hacer es seguir con el pensamiento de lo que hemos ya cubierto sobre lo que es la sinodalidad y lo que podemos aprender de la Sagrada Familia sobre la sinodalidad. So first, I want to highlight that there are two blind men. And in of itself, I already give you the context of communion. And the beauty that two blind men have come together, and most likely their source of union is their own poverty, their own handicap. They're unable to see, and that has become a commonplace, a reference point. They share in a similar struggle, therefore they've come to know each other through their common struggle of not being able to see. Like the play of word I think I saw this in a movie, but I love that when we speak about intimacy, an intimate union, communion, and the word of into me you see. Somehow the sharing of the struggles between the two blind men gave them a communion, an intimate union, because they were both sharing in the same struggle. Give you in the conferences that I've given so far, I've mentioned how it is in our lowliness, like Mary, like Joseph singing the Magnifica. They stay in their lowliness, and from their lowliness, they stay in openness to God, and His mercy comes and does great things in poverty, in humility, in smallness. So we're about to see the story unfold of two blind persons who come in communion through their own poverty, their lowliness. And they know themselves in need, and therefore they're seeking healing, they're seeking answers. So as I am about to go into Spanish, I want you to reflect in this. What is the handicap that you have? The blindness that you may have, the struggle that you have, that which causes you to stay in poverty, in smallness, in littleness, remain lowly. What is that struggle? And do you believe that through that struggle that you have, that lowliness, that poverty, do you believe that it could be the place of great intimate union with others? Reflect upon that and ask for the grace of humility as you search for an answer. En el Evangelio narra que hay dos ciegos. Y el hecho de que son dos ya nos pone el contexto de la comunión. Y recordar que, como he dado en las conferencias, la comunión se da desde lo más profundo de nuestra pequeñez. Para así cantar y compartir en el Magnífica de María y San José, que dicen, desde mi pobreza el Señor ha mirado en la pequeñez de tu esclavo. Lo dice María, pero María como portavoz de San José, lo dice también San José. Les pregunto a ustedes, ¿ustedes creen que es posible que desde ese vacío existencial, desde esa pobreza, desde esa pequeñez que todos tenemos, crees tú que puede ser el contexto para comunión? Para experimentar una intimidad profunda en comunión con otros desde nuestra pobreza. Un punto para hacer examinación de conciencia y una pregunta de fe. ¿Lo creo o no lo creo? Y pidamos la gracia de la humildad para poder, a ejemplo de San José y María, quedarnos en pequeñez para que en misericordia, la misericordia de Dios pueda hacer obras grandes en nosotros. Do you believe that in your lowliness, the context for great union. They both cried out in a unison to Jesus, "Son of David, have pity on us." This is prayer. Not just communion to blind persons, but at the same time, this is prayer. Both of them coming together in their handicap, in their lowliness, in their poverty, in their smallness, begging for mercy. Asking for mercy. Prayer. Do we come together in communion within our own brokenness? And do we turn to God, the source of healing, the source of life, and to beg as a prayer, to beg for mercy? Another question to examine ourselves. Do you believe that through your smallness, brokenness, imperfections, lowliness, you believe that through it, God can make great things? It is when I'm weak that then I am strong. If we believe in God who is a loving Father, then we must believe that even the struggles that the Father allows, He allows them because through them He's working something greater. It's a great act of faith. Do you believe that? Do you believe that God is a loving Father? That He's all powerful. And whatever struggles you have that remind you of your own poverty, of your own loneliness, your smallness, through it, God wants to work greatness in you. Do you believe that? Los dos en comunión expresan una oración y dicen, Hijo de David, ten misericordia de nosotros. De la comunión a la oración. Y una oración en la cual, unidos en nuestra pobreza, en nuestra ceguedad, nos unimos a rogar, a orar y pedir misericordia sobre nosotros. Pregunto, una pregunta para examinarnos, una pregunta para renovar nuestra fe. ¿Crees que tu pequeñez, tu debilidad, lo que estás sufriendo, lo que te humilla, lo que te mantiene humilde, crees que eso tiene el poder y por ello quiere Dios hacer algo mayor? Recordemos que Dios es todopoderoso y que es un Dios que nos ama. Es decir, que aquello con que sufrimos, el Padre por amor lo permite y por amor quiere hacer algo mayor por medio de ello. El famoso dicho, no hay mal que por bien no venga. ¿Crees tú que no solamente el contexto de comunión con otros, mi pobreza, mis impedimentos, sino que también es el contexto donde Dios quiere hacer obras grandes en nosotros? I find it, you know, beautiful as I was praying in the gospel, and we may take it for granted, but there are two blind men who followed Jesus. And when Jesus entered the house, they approached him. Let's not forget, they were blind. How are they able to follow Jesus? How are they able to approach Jesus? They can't see where he's at. The way they do so is by listening. They have to listen to the sounds, the constant noise that is around us, so as to know where, oh no, that sounds like there's a close, there's something there. No, no, you have to listen to the sounds around you. You have to feel your way around if you're blind. You gotta stumble. You sense, you feel, you're touching, you're hearing the noises. Okay, there's a, no, not that way. There, let's go this. And then once in a while, you hear the voice of Jesus. Oh, there it is. Let's go that way. It's the part of listening that we all should be doing. In our own struggles, yes, We're bumping our ways, walking, journeying together, listening to the sounds that are around us, the signs of the times, but ultimately just paying attention to the little voices of Jesus once in a while when he speaks. Oh, there, go, let's go that way. But they're walking together. You could say this is the blind leading the blind. But they're walking together, feeling, listening, stumbling, but guided by listening to the voice of Jesus. Do you have the courage and the determination like these two blind persons to walk even when you're not able to see? That's courage. And that's determination. I imagine they probably fell a couple of times. Just get up, keep going. I can feel it. I know he's getting closer. We're getting closer to him. Another question to examine ourselves. Do you have the courage, the determination to journey together? Even we may be blind, and it's not the case of the blind leading the blind, but the case of listening to all the sounds around us and ultimately awaiting for the sound of the Master, of Jesus, to speak. Interesante que cuando leemos este evangelio, ciegos que seguían a Jesús, que cuando Jesús entró a la casa, se le acercaron. No se nos olvide, son ciegos. ¿Cómo pudieron ellos seguir a Cristo? ¡No pueden ver! Tendrán que estar tocando las paredes, sintiendo, a ver, intuyendo, prestar atención a los sonidos, qué sonidos hay en mi alrededor, y sobre todo, esperar cautelosamente esa pequeña voz de Cristo que de vez en cuando se oye en la muchedumbre. ¡Es allá! ¡Sigue para allá! No es el ciego que está guiando el ciego, sino dos juntos, en valentía, con determinación, sea el costo de lo que sea, sintiendo, tropezando, cayéndose, levantándose, detectando sonidos y sobre todo buscando la voz del Señor. This is what the process of synodality is all about. Is we who somehow have grown blind with the desire to see. And the words of Pope Francis is, this whole process is for us to discern, to listen, to envision the church that God wants us to be for the third millennium. But it's a church that prays in communion, that joins hands in our brokenness, in our poverty, in our loneliness, but together. Stumbling, yes, feeling our way around, but on the way, yes, detecting the voices of the time, other people speaking, but ultimately trying to discern the voice of the Spirit, indicating us the direction that we should go to be as a church in the third millennium. How does it look like? Well, I don't know, we're blind. And therefore we're going to the Master to ask him, let us see. We want to see what you envision of your church. Let us see it so that we may grow and walk with greater confidence to fulfill that which you want of us. To be a synodal church. A church that prays together, that listens to each other, that discerns the Spirit. El proceso de sinodalidad es muy similar a lo que acabamos de estudiar con estos dos cieguitos. Nosotros, en cierta manera, estamos ciegos. Y el llamado de este proceso de sinodalidad es el Papa que nos pide, vamos a pedirle al Espíritu que nos guíe y nos deje ver cómo es que Él quiere que sea la Iglesia para el tercer milenio. Pero estamos ciegos, no la vemos. Pero con valentía, con determinación, en humildad, en pequeñez, unidos en nuestra pobreza, nos encaminamos, ¿sí? Tropezando, sintiendo las paredes, escuchando muchas voces, pero sobre todo discerniendo para escuchar la voz de Cristo, la voz del Espíritu Santo, la voz que nos indica el camino que debemos seguir como Iglesia. One last point from the gospel. The gospel, Jesus asked the blind man, "Do you believe that I can do this?" And if we apply that question for us in this synodal process, do you believe what it's about, what has started for us, this invitation to be part of a process of synodality? Do you believe that we can walk together? That we can be inclusive of all? That we can together participate in this journey? Do you believe that we can truly pray from our poverty and enter in deep communion with one another? Do you believe that we are able to listen and to hear to those who are not here and to stay at the foot of their crosses as they share their stories? And often it will feel like we are being crucified. But do you believe we can do this? Or even more, the question would be, because in humility the answer should be, no, in ourselves and our brokenness as humans, this will be impossible for us to do. Good. We're back in humility, in lowliness. And from there, then we can say in faith, we can't, but you can, God. And to you, we surrender. To you, we trust. And in you who are able to make of the impossible possible, to you we direct ourselves. Because in you, yes, we could be inclusive of one another. Yes, we could even listen to things that are difficult to hear. Yes, it is possible, even in the midst of opposition, of differences, of conflict, we still can be one. Not by our merits, but by your power, Lord. By the power of the Holy Spirit. Yes, I believe it is possible. La pregunta del Evangelio de Jesucristo a los ciegos es, ¿tú crees que yo puedo hacer esto? ¿Tú crees que nosotros podemos hacer este camino, este proceso sinodal? ¿Tú crees que en verdad podemos profundizar en una santa comunión desde nuestras pobrezas? ¿Crees que podemos orar y rogar juntos, más allá de las diferencias de cultura, de lengua, de raza? ¿Crees tú que podemos como iglesia ser inclusivos de hasta personas que piensan diferente a mí? ¿Lo crees o no lo crees? ¿Será posible o no será posible? ¿Podremos nosotros ver y tener la visión de lo que Dios quiere para nosotros como iglesia para el tercer milenio? ¿Podremos ver? La verdadera respuesta debe ser no. Si es por nuestra fuerza humana, no vamos a llegar muy lejos. Por eso estamos en el lío en que estamos. Para nosotros imposible, mas para Dios nada es imposible. Ultimately, there's one statement that really challenges us in regards to this process of synodality. It says, once Jesus asks, "Do you believe that I can do this for you?" Yes, we believe. And then Jesus says, "Let it be done for you according to your faith." It could happen, but it's in accordance to your faith. Do you believe in this process that just begun for the universal church, a process of synodality? Do you believe that this could happen? Because in accordance to your belief and your faith, it determines if it will happen or not. Let it be done according to your faith, according to what you believe. Jesus is ready to collaborate with us. He's given us His Spirit, divine Spirit, the divine Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, to make of the impossible possible. But it implies a collaboration, a participation from each one of us. And the fruitfulness or lack of fruits from this process of synodality depends on each one of us. Because it will happen only in accordance to what you believe. Wow. May our belief, as we come together, may our faith be that yes, we can be a synodal church, a church that journeys together with all people of all languages, of all races, that we can pray, that we can listen, that we can discern, and that we can fulfill the mission that has been entrusted to us. I believe it. The question remains, do you believe it? Does St. Paul believe it? Does the Diocese of St. Petersburg believe it? Does the Universal Church believe it? Let it be done for you according to your faith. Como último punto, las últimas palabras, después que Jesucristo le pregunta, ¿ustedes creen que yo puedo hacer esto? De lo imposible, posible. Y después le dice a los ciegos, a nosotros, nos dice, que os suceda conforme a vuestra fe. Según tu fe, determina si este proceso va a ser fructífero o no. La pregunta ahora queda en tus manos. Cada uno de nosotros está llamado a esa examinación de conciencia. Yo creo que esto es posible. Depende de tu respuesta en fe. Dependerá los frutos de este camino sinodal y que os suceda conforme a vuestra fe. Que así sea. Amén.